All right. Well, the state has about 1 week to come up with a corrective plan for its troubled Riverview Psychiatric Center. This comes after news this week that the hospital is in danger of losing $20 million in federal funding. The feds say they have found some serious problems with the hospital's use of corrections officers as well as tasers and handcuffs on some mental patients there. Meantime, lawmakers are expected to vote next week during a special session on a bill to create a hospital-level mental health unit in the Department of Corrections. That proposal would cost around $3 million a year. WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley is here now with the latest on Riverview. Jim.
Tracy, that $20 million in federal funds represents nearly half of Riverview's total operating budget. So we're talking about a lot of money here. And we were told today that a plan of correction has been submitted, and the superintendent, Louise McEwen, was not available to comment today as she was busy with conference calls to the federal officials trying to avert the potential loss of funds. Maine's Riverview Psychiatric Facility is in trouble with the feds after a report found that deputies used tasers and handcuffs to subdue aggressive patients. This after the Maine Department of Corrections asked for extra security here because of significant assaults on hospital workers. Other problems cited at the 92-bed facility: overcrowding and inadequate staffing. Employees told us off camera today that they are continually assaulted by out-of-control patients, those with or without criminal backgrounds. That's where the county deputies come in, using tasers and handcuffs against federal regulations, and the reason their funding is in jeopardy. As the psychiatric hospital fights to get back into compliance with the feds, the debate rages on about how to handle aggressive patients. Representative Mark Dion has a unique perspective, a former sheriff of Cumberland County who oversaw the county jail. He supports the use of tasers.
There's plenty of data to show that a taser, when properly applied, reduces injury to all parties, security staff, as well as inmates, or as well as patients. So I think there has to be some vigorous discussion with the federal government about that. There's a new day going on in psychiatric facilities, and we're having a population that is violent.
On the other hand, the executive director of the National Alliance on Mental Illness says there's a better way, better training for staffers who can learn how to diffuse a situation before it gets out of control.
We do a CIT program here, crisis intervention training, where we go out and train local law enforcement on how best to interact and to de-escalate when they encounter a person with mental illness. We need to make sure that folks in corrections have that kind of training, and employees in mental health facilities have that kind of training.
A September 2nd deadline looms for a decision on that $20 million in federal funding. Meanwhile, the legislature is looking long-term, expected to talk about a bill, once again, that would establish a new mental health unit within the state prison in Warren, alleviating some of the problems faced at Riverview. We're live in the studio. Jim Keithley, WMTW News.